areas you really want to hit between now and signing?
Well, I'm a secondary guy, so you know, we have to have more depth in the secondary, so that would be one of our key deals to look around and shake a couple branches and see if we can get a couple of DBs to fall off and guys that can cover and do things in that department. But obviously, front guys going to be the most important thing that we do. We have to be good up front. We have to be able to stop the run. We got to be able to rush the quarterback. So, you know, we're going to do those things, and we're identifying our roster as we kind of go through everything and see exactly what we need and what we need to be a great defense.
One of those guys was Jamarcus King, who enrolled early and signed and everything, so you could talk about him. You maybe talk about some of the things you liked about him.
Jamarcus is a really talented young man. He got great length. He got ball skills. He was a former receiver, quarterback in high school. So we're very excited about having the opportunity to get a chance to work with Jamarcus. So he's the kind of guy that we want in our program. He's an outstanding young man who comes from a great family, and we're excited to have him a part.
Going back to Sky Moore, I know you said you had a little bit of interaction with him. What were some of the things that Coach Muschamp said it was a smart decision, an informed decision? How much of a role did you try and play in that, or did you allow Coach Muschamp to handle more of that?
Yeah, Coach Muschamp kind of handled Sky. You know, Sky was thinking about coming out. And, you know, with Coach Muschamp's background, my background in defensive play, Sky thought it was in the best interest for him to come back and work under our system and help develop his skills and give him some more variety and things that he do on the defensive side of the football. So it'll be exciting to get him back, and he's excited, we're excited, and he's going to be a part of our program.
You actually had Chris Lamont's committed to you at Florida, and now you get to coach him again. Talk a little bit about your knowledge of Chris. I know you hadn't followed him for 2 years probably, but your knowledge of Chris and how you could see him teaming up on that defensive secondary.
Yeah, it's a couple of those guys that turned me down when I was other places. So, you know, when the first thing when we meet on Sunday, that'll be one of the things that I hit him on. You know, all these guys that didn't call me, that kind of ran away from me, I found them. But I'm excited about it. It's a couple of guys that I know during the process. But those guys were obviously guys that I recruited and guys that I like and guys that got the length and all the different things that we look for in the corner and other positions on our football team. So I'm just excited about getting a chance to work with those guys and help develop the craft.
Kier Thomas is a guy you recruited, and I believe you can talk about. Can't talk about him.
I cannot.
Okay. All right, that's no problem. Talk about the buck position and how you utilize that, and kind of what that means. Gamecock fans are used to the spur position.
Mm-hmm.
I think the buck's a little bit different.
All right, our buck is a primary position for us. It's a pass rusher that can do multiple things. He can stand up and take first to the flat and rush the quarterback and line in different spots, or he can put his hand in the dirt. So it's a primary position for us. It's always been a position of need. And we looking for the best pass rushers in the country that got enough girth that they can play six technique and play on the open side if they have to, all right, and be able to rush the quarterback.
When you get into spring ball, what's the main thing you have to accomplish? Is it players learning terminology? Is it just teaching the simple system? What's the biggest thing you have to do in those 15 practices?
Mentality. The other stuff will take care of itself. One thing that we're going to focus on our guys is mentality. The thing that we're going to talk about all the time is turnovers. Getting the football. We are about the football. We are a ball-driven organization. And we want to get the football back to our offense so they can score points. Kirk promised me that he's going to give us a bunch of points, and I told him I'd give him the ball a bunch of times. So we're excited about that, and that's going to be one of the primary focuses, just building toughness and having that edge, that blue-collar mentality, that we will outwork our opponents.
Where do you see offenses? You've been in the SEC a long time, from playing at Auburn to coaching at Florida back home. Where do you see offenses going over the next 5 or 10 years?
Obviously, the running quarterback is a thing that probably will never die now. I mean, we got guys that can really, you know, do nice things with the football, whether it's throw it or run it, and the zone read game and all the different things like that. So we got to have different ways to take certain things away game by game and take away what they do best. But offensively, you still got, that's the SEC is so beautiful. It's something like the NFL. You know, you got different varieties of offenses, whether it be two back, whether it be spread. So, I mean, you got to defend everything in this league.
Thanks, Coach.
You've probably been asked this already, but was it a hard decision to come to Columbia? And what was your ultimate selling factor?
Have you been downtown?
Absolutely.
Oh, it's unbelievable. It wasn't a hard decision. I'm very excited about it. Obviously, coming with Coach Muschamp, I've been with him for a long time now. We have a relationship, and I trust him and trust his ability, and he's the best man for the job. So I was just excited to be a part of his staff. I'm excited that he wanted me to be a part of his staff, and he's assembled a great staff, just getting around these guys. Some of these guys I didn't know all the way, and I'm just having a week or so to kind of get united with those guys, and I really think he did a great job of just assembling a great staff. But Columbia is a great city. It gives you everything you want. It gives you the college atmosphere, and then you can drive down a mile or so, and then you get the downtown life, and I'm excited about that because all the places I've coached, I never had that. And just the city feel also with the college environment. So I'm excited about that. And, you know, for me playing here and coaching here, the game day atmosphere is the thing that stick out to me the most. These fans are pretty cocky. And I'm excited about it, and I can't wait to get into William Rice and get this thing rolling.
What do you think your biggest challenge is coming in as a part of the staff?
You know, always getting the kids to buy in. That'll probably be the primary thing, and that'll be the thing that we'll focus on the most. And when I talk in terms of mentality, that's what I'm talking about. Understanding how we do things and doing things the right way on and off the football field. And that'll be one of the hardest things to do, and that's something that we're ready for the challenge.
How big of it was the sigh relief? How big was your sigh relief when Scott Moore decided to come back? And how does he fit in your system?
He fits the system well because he's a kid that's versatile. And in our defense, we need guys that can play multiple positions, whether we rush him off the edge, whether we put him back in safety and utilize him in that department, whether he play linebacker in the core. So, I mean, a guy with that type of abilities is always exciting to get in your program.
And South Carolina's defense wasn't what it was about 3 years ago when they were having 11 wins that kind of took a dip. What's the biggest challenge to make sure that it gets back to where it was?
It's all about the football. We'll preach to our guys, we'll have signs all over the place about turning the ball over. Right? We have to get the football and create positive momentum for our offense. And that's going to be one of the challenges, and that'll be one of the things that the big emphasis that we talk upon this spring is getting the football, all right, and having that mentality that we're going to outwork our opponents, we're going to be tougher than our opponents, and we're going to outhit our opponents.
And coming in a couple weeks ago, you've been recruiting. Have you been able to sleep at all? Have you get something to eat at all, or was it just been?
All I need is 4 hours.
Right.
Yeah. If I get me 4 hours, I'm fine. So, you know, we've been working really hard, just trying to get caught up in recruiting, just building a relationship with some of the guys in South Carolina, some of the guys that kind of them resurfaced down there in Florida and in Georgia. But all these guys that Coach has assembled on the staff, they have good relationships with a certain amount of kids. So we're just trying to co-mingle those guys and see if South Carolina's a fit. And that's the one thing about us. We don't want to rush into any decision and just get any guy in the program. We want to get guys that fit what we do systematically. We want to get guys that fit what we do as far as Columbia, the city. I mean, certain guys. So it's something that we're really looking forward to and I'm excited about.
And what's kind of your base defense that you're playing on this call?
Right now, again, that's as we evaluate what we have. Obviously, we've been some 3-4, we've been some 4-3. Depending on the guys that we have on roster and the ability that they have to do certain things, then we kind of focus on that when we get to that. But right now, just learning the football team, learning our guys, it'll probably be the next step when we get off the road recruiting and then implementing our system and our plan and seeing what we do. If we have guys that can play bump man-to-man, that's what we've done in the past, then we want to play bump man-to-man. But if we have guys that's not able to do that right now, then we're not going to say this is what we do is either our way or the highway. No, we're going to do what we do, all right, that gives us the best chance to win. And that's what it's about. The fun is in winning, and we're going to give our kids the best chance to do that.
After coaching Auburn for a season and then watching them go in the Birmingham Bowl and tame Memphis, you know, a really high-powered offense mm-hmm. to just, I think, 205 yards, mm-hmm. what did you think of that performance? And obviously Lance over there coached those guys. Were you surprised that they had such a good ending to the season?
Well, wasn't surprised at all. Lance is a phenomenal football coach, very smart, understands the scheme and understand the players, and so we were just excited to be able to get him from them. But you know, wasn't surprised at all. We have been doing a really good job of guys developing from the beginning of the season to the end of the season, just playing with a different speed and a different type momentum. So wasn't surprised at all. Was actually very excited. Obviously, I went to school there and always rooting for the Tigers unless the Gamecock playing them now. So.
How do you feel about that?
And that's the Auburn Tiger. That's sure not the other Tiger.
How do you feel about just the secondary for Auburn going into next season and where they're at right now after?
We have some really talented young men, but, you know, people don't want to talk about another football team. Want to focus on our football team and focus on, you know, trying to develop these guys to be the best possible they can be. And that's kind of our focus right now. So it's not about anyone else. It's about us. It's about how can we develop our roster to best